Good morning. I'm coming with you for the verse of the day. John 6 and 35. And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger, and he that believeth on me shall never thirst.
Good afternoon, CT. Good afternoon to you all that are watching on live, YouTube, on Facebook. Amen. We love the Lord. I'm going to invite you to stand with us. Slow it down a little bit. Invite you to stand with us and worship with us this morning. We're just going to tell the Lord how much we love him and how much we exalt him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. If you know that, sing that with us. I love you, Lord, and I live my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. Let's say, we exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. Oh, Lord. Say that again. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. Oh Lord, we exalt thee. We exalt. We exalt thee, oh Lord. Let's say it again. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. Oh, we exalt thee. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, oh yes we do, we exalt thee, oh Lord, let's say I exalt thee, I exalt thee. Yes, I do. I exalt thee. I exalt. worship, through prayer, hallelujah, we exalt thee, oh, go hallelujah. You, Lord, we exalt you, God. Glory, 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 glory. We exalt you, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Come on, let's put our hands together for Jesus, because we're alive today and we then came, walked up in here in the house of prayer. This is the house of prayer. This is not your church, or your church. This is the house of prayer. Let us bow our heads. Father God, in the name of Jesus, forgive us on today. Keep us from all hurt, harm, and danger. Let us let our pastor arrive here safely. Watch over the first family in the name of Jesus. And Lord, let the word go out, Lord, to each and every home in the name of Jesus. Save our children. Save our children. Save our children in the name of Jesus. Lord, bless us with financial blessings. Bless us with financial blessings. Bless us with homes. Bless us with cars in the name of Jesus, as is in your will. This we ask in your name. And Lord, before we go here, we want to be saved, sanctified, and filled with the precious Holy Ghost. Save somebody on today. Fill somebody on today in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We will bless the Lord. We will bless the Lord as we exalt him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank the Lord for the sacrifice that he made for us on Calvary, shedding his blood so that we can live. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We lift our hands, hallelujah, and we praise your name, God. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask Brother Ed and Sister Pat and Sister Dale, y'all come up and help me this morning. Brother Ed, will you come on up? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, 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 hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, let's continue to worship the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We bless the Lord, we bless the Lord, we bless the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory, glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
with my hands lifted up and my mouth filled with praise, with the heart of thanksgiving, I will bless thee, O Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With my hands lifted up.
With my hands lifted up.
Yes, Lord. And my mouth filled with praise.
And my mouth filled with praise.
With the heart.
With the heart of thanksgiving.
I will bless the Lord. 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 I will bless you, Lord. Even in the good times and the bad times, I will bless the Lord. In the happy and the sad times, I will bless the Lord. 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 Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Lord, I shall bless the Lord. Yeah. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord with me. Praises, his praises, his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I will bless you, Lord. 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 Through the thick and the thin. I will bless you, Lord. Through the good and the bad. I will bless you, Lord. 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 Yeah, yeah. At all times and again, his praises shall be in my mouth. His praises shall be in my mouth. His praises shall be in my mouth. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood you shed for me. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood you shed for me.
Let's say it again, everybody. Thank you for the blood.
Thank you for the blood.
Lord, I thank you for the blood.
Oh, thank you for the blood you shed for me. Thank you for the blood.
Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood you shed for me.
As the musicians play softly, I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 11:28-30, and it reads, "But a person must prayerfully examine himself and his relationship to Christ. And only when he has done so should he eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without solemn reverence and heartfelt gratitude for the sacrifice of Christ eats and drinks a judgment on himself if he does not recognize the body of Christ. That careless and unworthy participation is the reason why many among you are weak and sick, and a number sleep in death." Take a minute before we take this communion to submit your life over to Christ. We surrender our hearts to you. We surrender our minds to you. We surrender our soul to you. We surrender our spirit to you. All our wants, all our desires for our life, we give way to your wants and your desires for us. Be glorified in our hearts. Be glorified in our minds. Be glorified in our spirit. We don't just take this because it's just something to do on the first Sunday. But we truly recognize, we acknowledge, and we recognize what you did for us. And we say thank you for the blood you shed for us. And not only with our mouth do we say it, but Lord, we also say it with our actions. We honor you, we bless you, we praise and worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. The Lord, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread as I now do. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat. This do in remembrance of me." After the same manner also, he took the cup, as I now do, ministering in his name. When he had supped, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood. This do, and as often as you drink it, you do so in remembrance of me." Lord, we thank you. Let's close this communion time out, giving God thanks one more time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you for the blood you shed for me. Oh, thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for the blood you shed for me. There's power in the blood.
There is power in the blood. Power in the blood. Power in the blood you shed for me. There is power in the blood.
There is
power in the blood.
Power in
the blood you shed for me.
There's power, power, wonder-working power. There is
power,
power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb.
There is power,
power, wonder-working power in the precious blood
of the Lamb.
Let's sing it again, everyone.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb.
There is power,
power,
oh,
wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Let's sing it again. There's power.
There is power, power,
wonder-working power.
In the blood.
In the blood.
In the blood
of the Lamb.
Power,
wonder working power
in the
precious blood of the Lamb.
Let's sing it one more time, church. There is power.
There is power, power, wonder working power
in the blood
of the Lamb. Power, power, wonder-work, power
in the precious blood of the Lamb. In the precious blood of the Lamb. In the precious blood of the Lamb. In the precious blood. Of the Lamb.
In the precious blood of the Lamb.
Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you for your sacrifice for us. Thank you for your sacrifice for us. Thank you for your sacrifice for us. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank God for each of you that's here today. Thank God for each of you that are online. God is good to us. And he deserves our praise. He deserves the glory that we give him. He deserves the honor that we give him. He deserves it all. Is that right? We pray, God, that your will would be done. We pray that no flesh will be glorified. We pray right now for Mother Dobbs that you would touch her heart, touch her mind, her spirit. I pray that her faith would be lifted. Hallelujah. You've healed her before. You can do it again. You've healed before and you can do it again. You've healed before and you can do it again. Is there any in the room that is sick today? If there's anyone in this room that is sick, I want you to know that the Lord is your healer. And you have to have faith in him and believe that he can heal you. You have to believe that he's bigger than your sickness. You have to believe that he's bigger than your sickness. And let me also say this. When we nurse problems of whatever kind, y'all know what I mean when I say nurse them? When we nurse those things, we just hold on to them. How can God heal? How can God fix it? When you're holding on to it and you're making it a priority. I'm sick, I'm sick, I'm hurt, I'm hurt, I'm messed up, I got problems, 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 problems. That's nursing them. You're just constantly speaking it, speaking it, speaking it, saying it, speaking it, and your actions are following that. You're speaking it, saying it, and your actions are following that. Do y'all hear me today? How can God come in? The healing and the different things like this that we're asking God to do, they happen according to our what? According to our faith. According to our faith. Do you believe? Everyone, I need you to come and take this from me. Do you believe that God can handle whatever it is? Amen. You've got to truly believe that God can handle it. You've got to believe. I want you to get in your mind. I need you to get in your heart. I need you to get in your spirit, whatever that challenge is. whatever that problem is, whatever that obstacle is, and there's two words I want you to say, and then you can fill in whatever other words that need to go behind it. But I want you to get those things in your mind. Are they in your mind? Now, I simply want you to say, God can. Now, if it's sickness, you say, God can heal. If it's a challenge, God can handle it. Problem, God can do it. God, what? Can. God, what? God, what? God, what? God can. God can. God can. God can. God can. But you have to want him to. I've said this before. There are people who seem to like problems, seem to like having them because they draw attention from other people. They seem to like having issues because other people say, oh, they get a lot of that from other people. Oh, oh, and they just love that. Oh, come on, everybody pat me on the back because I'm having a problem. Oh, and they love that. And you know what? All you're doing is magnifying that thing. And after a while, what are you going to do when those people quit saying, oh, and you've magnified that problem? It's got you at that point. God can. I pray that the Lord will change the minds of people who like the attention that they get from having a problem. Lord, touch their minds. Lord, change their minds. Help them to know that you're greater than all of these problems. That has been out in the front yard for 6-7 years almost. God is greater than your problems. Do you all believe that? Then say it one more time. God can. And with God, you can get through it. With God, you can get through it. Everybody say that. With God, I can get through it. Come on. With God, I can get through it. Say it again. With God, I can get through it. Clap your hands and praise God for that. Pray, Lord, that you would be glorified as I go into this today. No flesh be glorified, but I give you the glory, Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. I praise God for again for all of you that are here. I ask you to stay in prayer for Lady Rhonda as she's at work. I thank God for each of you, even for those of you who are online. While you're smacking on ribs, at least you tuned into the service. I appreciate it. And I want to encourage you all, this coming Wednesday night, we will start including Bible study with the prayer. Starting this coming Wednesday night at 7, we're going to start to include Bible study with the prayer. And I want to invite each member to come. Amen. I want to invite each member to come. If you got to bring your dinner with you, bring it with you. But don't miss these times of prayer and discussing whatever the Lord puts on our hearts to share. Let's come together and help and encourage each other, pray for each other, inspire each other, lift each other. Amen. Amen. And I know that that will take place when we do this. We want to make God a priority. We want to make God a priority. I repeat, we want to make God a priority. As a matter of fact, our highest priority. God should be number one in our life. I'm married, I have a beautiful wife, and I thank God for her, but God is my number one over my wife, and she would say the same about me. We're glad to be married, but we put God above each other. Those of you who are blessed to have a good amount of money in your pocket, don't make that your God. Let God be God. Do y'all hear that? You have to be careful because it can sneak in, and you will get in the spirit, and you'll open your eyes, and you'll see God will let you know. How many of you can understand sometimes when you're in the presence of God, he gives you correction. He don't just pat you on the back and say you've done well. He also will tell you the things you need to stop doing and start doing and change doing when you're in the spirit. Let God be first in your life. Let God be first in your life. Mark 12, 29 through 31, Jesus replied, you're not going to see it on the screen because I didn't give it to Brother Alpha. So just flow with me as if we don't have screens. Mark 12, 29 through 31, Jesus replied, the most important commandment is this. Listen, O Israel, the Lord our God is the one and only Lord. And you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. Love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. The second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. No other commandment is greater than these. Do you love your neighbor? Do you love the people you sitting by right now? Those of you online, do you love the people that's in the room with you? Do you truly love them, or are you just saying that because it's the churchy thing to say? Because yes would be the churchy answer to say, but do you truly love them? When we're a family like this, Christian Tabernacle, we've got to develop relationships with each other so we can truly, 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 one, even get to know each other, and two, be able to say, I love you, my brother. I love you, my sister. Do y'all understand that? Let's not, and I'm not saying this is happening, I don't know if this is happening, but I don't want to see this happen in Christian Tabernacle, for us to be the kind of members that come service after service after Sunday after Sunday after Wednesday, and you don't know each other's names. Let's work to develop relationships with each other. Let's work to develop relationships with each other. You don't know what kind of help you have in this room. You don't know what kind of words of wisdom and advice and testimonies you have that will change your life that's in this room. Do y'all hear that? Yeah, let's do that. Let's love God and love each other. Jesus clearly stated the greatest priorities for every one of us is to do just that. Love God and love others and do it with everything that we have. Y'all got that? Love God and love others and do it with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. Joshua 24 and 15, choose today who you're going to serve. Choose today who you're going to serve. As for me and my family, we'll serve who? The Lord. As for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. John 3:16, God loved the world so much that he gave his one and only son so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. Obeying God and accepting the gift of salvation from Jesus are also high priorities. Obeying God and giving your life to Christ should be high priority in our lives. Nothing affects our eternal future as importantly as this. How many of y'all do understand that heaven and hell are real? Heaven and hell are real. And just because you go to church don't automatically mean you signed your ticket to heaven. Just because you're my friend don't mean you're going to heaven. Just because you speak and I smile and shake your hand don't mean you're going to heaven. Just because you feel a warm sensation go down your back when the preacher lay hands on you and you cry don't mean you're going to heaven. And I don't have to ask you who in this room wants to go to hell. I know nobody wants to go. So that leads to the next question. What are you doing to prove that to God? What are you doing to prove to God that you want to see him one day in heaven? Giving my life to Christ was the greatest decision I ever made. Can anybody else agree with that with your life? Amen. Giving my life to Christ was the best decision I ever made. And it didn't mean problems didn't come. Actually, I think they tripled. Because the devil got mad when I gave my life to Christ. But the thing about it is I had him on my side to fight through all of those temptations and problems. Any witnesses on that? Amen. Nothing affects our eternal future as importantly as that. Wait, not just our eternal future, but our immediate life. My life is greater because I have Jesus Christ first in my life. I don't have everything I want materially, but my life is greater than what it used to be. Because Jesus is first in my life. I have people who are smiling in my, and I ain't the only one, I have people who are smiling in my face and stabbing me in the back, smiling in my face and planning my downfall, smiling in my face and say, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to see if he going to keep praising God. I'm going to do this, and I'm going to try this, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to see if he going to keep lifting God up. Yes, I am, because my relationship with God is greater than my relationship with you. I have to answer to him for my actions. Do y'all hear that? I don't have to answer to you for my actions. I have to answer to the one that made me. You didn't make me, God did. I have to answer to him for what I do. I have to watch this one, because you do too. I have to answer to him for how I treat you, even though I know you don't like me. Can anybody relate to that? I got to answer to God for how I treat you. My actions. What you do to me, I go to God, I stand before God. Lord, they did this to me and they did that to me. God's going to say, but what did? So, knowing that, a priority of mine is looking in the mirror at myself to make sure I'm right. Yeah. That's a priority. Looking in the mirror at myself to make sure I'm right, it's a priority to make sure I'm lined up with the leadership that God has called over me. Oh, I'm going to repeat that one. It's a priority of mine. It's very important that I line up with the leaders that God has put over me. It's important that I line up with, that I get to know, have a relationship with, that I line up with, that I humble myself under the leader that God has called over me. Because when I'm fighting my God-called leader, I'm fighting God. Okay. I guess I got to somebody with that one. But I'm not going back on that. If God has called me to be under a certain person's leadership, I got to flow with what God tells them to do. And I have to communicate with them. I have to get to know them, and they have to get to know me. Y'all hearing me today? Priority. How do I know what's really important? Proverbs 3:6, seek his will in all you do. The New Living Translation reads, and he'll show you which path to take. Again, how do I know what's really important? Seek the will of God, and he'll show you what path to take. What am I talking about today? Priorities. Just that one word, priorities. That's the title, Brother Alpha. Priorities. Haggai 1:9, you hoped for rich harvest, but they were poor. And when you brought your harvest home, I blew it away. Why? Because my house lies in ruins, says the Lord of Heaven's armies, while all of you are busy building your own fine houses. Priorities are scales where your love for God is weighed. Be sure to take care of God's agenda. Be sure to take care of God's agenda for you. Are y'all listening to me today? If all of your priorities focus only on what's best for you, you're not going to achieve God's best for you. You're not going to achieve his best for you. When you're making sure that you're the priority, you're not achieving his best for you. How many people have ever been down and you made it your business to go and lift somebody else up? And God, in return, lifted you up? Can anybody relate to that? You were down and you went and lifted someone else up, and that came back to you. What's best for me? What's best for me? What's best for me? What's best for me? What's best for you is to do what God wants you to do. That's what's best for you. Always seek his input before you make the decision. And don't just tell him what you need him to do. Wait on him to answer. Don't just say, I need you to do this, Lord. I need you to do that, Lord. But you don't take the time to listen to him. Come on, think about that in your two-way conversations that you have with different people. You don't want to hear them say anything back to you? You ask them to do something, then you just walk off? That don't make a lot of sense, does it? You ask them to do something, then you leave? You want to hear a response. And in order to hear the response, you got to stop talking. In order to hear the response, you've got to be quiet. You've got to listen and let them talk back. Well, it's the same way in prayer. We pray, we pray, we pray, and then we listen. We pray and we listen. We pray and we listen. We pray and we listen. We don't just pray and leave. We don't just pray and get up and do. We pray and listen. Y'all got that? It's not just what's best for me. It's, Lord, what do you want? When we are considering a course of action, we've got to ask ourselves, Lord, is this a priority to you? I've said this before, you all. I've said this before, you all. If God is against it, we should be against it. Let's look at what's going on in our world today. If God is for it, we should be for it. If God is against it, we should be against it. Somebody say amen to that. Amen. Say amen again to that. Amen. Let's continue to seek his wisdom. Let's continue to seek his wisdom. And that's going to help us to be able to discern the right priorities. 1 Kings 3:9 says, give me an understanding heart so I can know the difference between right and wrong. That's 1 Kings 3:9. And then Matthew 6:33, which is my scripture for life. Seek God's kingdom above all else. First seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And the New Living says, and live righteously, and he'll give you everything you need. Seek God's kingdom first. Seek God's kingdom above all else, and he'll give you everything you need. Somebody say amen. Amen. be intentional about lining up with God. Then you're going to begin to see a full life when you be intentional about lining up with God. Be intentional about lining up with God. It's then that you will begin to have a full life. There is no, and this is a repeat, there is no best life if God is not first. Because you didn't create yourself. He created you, which means he knows you better than you know you. There is no best life if God is not first in your life. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and don't lean to your own understanding in all your ways. Acknowledge him and he will show you the path to take. He will direct your path. Putting him first helps to put all of the other priorities in your life in order. Putting him first puts the other priorities in order. And what are some of the benefits of putting God first and all the other priorities in order? What are some of the benefits of having the right priorities? And what are some of the dangers of having the wrong ones? I got two scriptures for you. Psalms 128, 1 and 2. Psalms 128, 1 and 2. How joyful are those who fear the Lord. How joyful are those who follow his ways. You'll enjoy the fruit of your labor. You'll be prosperous. It says how joyful and prosperous you'll be. The right priorities bring lasting joy. I've heard some of your testimonies over the years, CT members, of when you were living what you thought was your best life and your priorities were off. And you all said in some of your testimonies over the years how you paid for some of those wrong decisions. I've heard you all say it in your testimonies, and I have my own of that. I've paid for doing whatever Keith wanted to do. I put a post on Facebook earlier in the week about I think it was a scripture about following our heart. I can't trust my heart. Did y'all get that? Because my heart is going to lead me to saying and doing some really foolish things. That's why I pray the way I do. Because my heart has messed me up a whole lot, Sister Pat. Following my heart has made me have to repent to a whole lot of people. Following my heart has made me have to repent to God a whole lot of times. I can't trust my heart. And yes, I'm saved. I'm sanctified. I'm filled with the Holy Ghost and burning fire and all that kind of stuff they say in their testimonies, but I'm still a human. I can't follow my heart. Maybe you can, but I can't because I'm flesh. Maybe some of y'all are super saved and y'all never do nothing wrong. I can't say that. And I know I'm making myself vulnerable to people who like to talk negative about preachers. I get that. But you'll be all right, because when you look at yourself in the mirror, you're going to see you just like me. In need of a savior. You just like me. In need of a healer. You just like me. In need of a deliverer. You just like me. Somebody say, forgive me, Lord. Why did I say that? For the times we followed our hearts and the sin that it led us to. Lasting joy comes from having our priorities right. A deep sense of satisfaction comes from having our priorities right. We know that we're doing the right thing. That makes a lasting impact and it pleases God. Having our priorities right. This is too basic for some of y'all, I get it. But for some people, this is life. And for those of you this is too basic for, I want you to do what I've been saying for 15 years now. Take this in and preach it to somebody else. And as you pour it out to somebody else, God will give you what you need. Wrong priorities lead to useless activity and unproductive worry. Wrong priorities will lead you to wasting your life. Some of you, your lives are being wasted, your mind is being wasted away because you're connected to wrong people. Your mind is being wasted. All of your thoughts and energy is being put into wrong connections and wrong relationships that God has told you himself. God has led other people to speak to you, and you've not received what they've said. There are some times and some situations where, and I am not, and y'all ought to know this, maybe you don't, I'm not a quick to cut off type of person. But there are some people that have to be cut off. There are some, it hurts. There are some people you have to say, nah, mm-mm. And they try all kinds of ways to get in your life, your heart, your mind. But you know, because they've proven to you that they're no good for you. And you still seeing the same things you saw when they were fully in your life. It's at that moment when you say, you know what? This is it. This is it. God hasn't called me to live this way. He wants me to have life and life abundantly, and I can't have it with you in my life acting like this. My father's words would be, way with you. Y'all know what that means? Way with you means you got to go. I repeat, I am not a cut off, what's that word? Cancel culture type of guy. But there are some times where some things, some situations, some relationships, at least for a season, have to be canceled. Because your peace of mind is at stake. I repeat, your peace of mind is at stake. Your peace of mind is at stake. And as long as they stay in there, they're chewing away. They're gnawing away. They're pulling. They're ripping away at your peace. They're ripping away your heart. They're ripping the life out of you. I know that I'm speaking to somebody. And you say, but if I don't have them, I don't have anybody. You're not giving God a chance. You're not giving God a chance to put somebody in your life. Maybe they won't have everything right about their life, but they will be at least willing to receive your help. You've tried to give them help, and they're not even receiving it. Come on. It's time to move on. Elder Polk, I don't remember the scripture. Some of you Bible scholars may know it, but Elder Polk put this scripture in my heart at a time when I really, really, really needed it because I was doing that. I was trying to pour in and give these words of life and words of wisdom and words of help to people who was just taking it and trashing it. And Elder Polk says simply to me, don't cast your pearls among the swine. Some of you are doing that. There's somebody in this room doing that. There's somebody online doing that. And I'm saying this to you from experience. It's stressful and it's unnecessary. Y'all don't have to play yet. It's stressful and it's unnecessary. It's stressful and it's unnecessary. It's stressful, which turns into making you sick physically. You don't even want to eat. Because you're so worried about them, but they don't care about you. Other than if you die, so they can fight over what you have. They don't care about you other than if you get out of the way so they can get what they want. I know I'm speaking to somebody today, and I'm here today to tell you, God hasn't called you to keep taking that. You don't have to keep taking that. And I don't mean getting in no fights with nobody either. You don't have to get in no fights with people like this. You just make the stand, and I mean make the stand. And you can't be wishy-washy. You can't be a punk. Because they're going to keep finding ways to step on you. I had a whole nother way to go today, and I couldn't do it, and maybe I'm supposed to start it next Sunday, and it's a message called Keep Cain Out of Your Life. It's talking about anger and a killing spirit. And I don't think today was the day to start that, so I went this way. That's why y'all didn't have the scriptures on the screen. Brother Al forgot the scriptures for that, but today wasn't the day for that. Because somebody needed to hear this. You need to quit letting them people hold you in bondage like this. You got to get up from that. And you have the power and authority. But what's going to happen to them? God created them. He'll take care of them. You, in other words, are headed towards the hospital. Because you are so caring and loving towards somebody who is trying to do away with you. You're so caring and loving, and we're supposed to love people. Yes, we are, but you can love them without them stepping on you like that. You can love them without them treating you like a dog. You can love them without the, wait a minute, some of them treat their dogs better than they've been treating. I had to take that back. Some of them treat their dog better than they've been treating you. You got to open your eyes and see that. Not all of this stuff calls for me to lay my hands on you. Some of this stuff calls for you simply saying this one very powerful word. Very powerful word. Oh, this word carries a whole lot of power. And you know what that word is? No. That word is no. You got to get to the place where, oh, you know what? I've been stomped on enough. No. You have stabbed me enough. No. I can't stop you from scheming on me, but I ain't gonna give you that power and authority that you want in my life. No more. No. You this and you this, and you might get cussed out. You might get talked about. They might, and if they on social media, they're definitely going to go online and say bad things about you to try to get other people on their side. Get used to it, but you still make your stand and say no. God has not called you. Yes. I'm a giver. I'm such a giver. But please understand this. There are Jezebels in this world. There are narcissists in this world who are looking for people like you to use you and to use you till you have nothing else to give. You should not want just to be with somebody that much to where they use you like that, and there's nothing that they are even close to thinking about giving back to you. You've got to love yourself. 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 You've got to value who God has made you. I'm not only speaking to single people about man and woman relationships. This can happen in all different kinds of relationships. This can happen with friends. This can happen with kids. This can happen with grandkids. How many of you understand our kids can do us like this? Our grandkids can do us like this. And they will worry you all the way to death. And when you die, they'll cry for 2 minutes and then they'll go fighting over all your stuff. If they don't start fighting at the funeral. You've got to make a stand. You're teaching them a lesson when you make a stand. You're teaching them you can't get away with all this stuff. But they not going to have nothing. They not going to have nobody without me. Yes, they will. Yes, they will. Man, I know I'm talking to somebody today. And I know that because I keep feeling the fight. I keep feeling, why is he on this? Why don't he get off of this? Because somebody needs it. If it's not you that need it, what did I just say like 7 minutes ago? It's for you to help somebody else with. You've got to get up. I don't always talk this way, and y'all know that, but you've got to get up and do it. It's either Joel Osteen or Joyce Meyer that says, and enjoy the life God gave you. You can't do it as long as you locked up and bound under these other people who don't even care anything about you. You got to get up. You got to get up. You've got to get up. Y'all receive this today? Thank you, Lord. I've done what you told me to do. I tossed and turned. Got up and walked around and exercised and everything, trying to get my mind in the right place. All day yesterday, all last night, all this morning. But Lord, I've done what you told me to do. And I ain't heard about it. I'm at peace with what you've had me to say. Now I pray that the people will just receive it and take it and share it with someone else. Take it and share it with someone else. They may not believe it, but that's going to open the way for you to be able to pour back into them as they share with someone else what you've had me to speak today. I pray that we would receive it. In the name of Jesus, I pray that those who are down on themselves, I pray for those who are lonely and just accepting anything and anybody in their life. I pray, God, that you will touch their minds and their hearts. I pray that you will touch their minds and their hearts. I pray that they will allow you to, because you want to. Yeah. You want to touch them. You want to give them better relationships. I pray that they will allow you to do that. I pray that they will allow you, ask you to come in and touch their hearts and help them to know their worth. Help them to know their value. Help them to know that they have a table in someone's life, and help them to know that they, again, as I said earlier, don't have to be, because you didn't create them to be stepped on and spit on and stepped over and beat on and cursed out. You didn't call us to just continually take that. And for some, God, the way out has already been provided. They're just not choosing it. Well, I pray that they will begin to choose it. And what's going to follow that? A level of peace like they have never experienced before. So God, I pray that they would make you their priority instead of those people or that person that they've been hanging on to. I pray that they would make you the priority. I pray that they would make you the priority instead of the narcissist in their life. I pray that they would make you the priority instead of the leeches in their life that's sucking them dry. I pray that they would make you the priority so that they can line themselves up with you and line themselves up with your will and line themselves up with the blessings that come along with being in your presence and the blessings that come along with being in your will. Because as long as they're constantly connected to these people who is taking the life out of them, they're going further and further away from your plan for them. And the great thing about you, Lord, is you're right there to help them. You're right there to help them. Right where they are, you're right there to help them. You're right there to lift them up. And I pray that they will look to you. I pray that they will look to you so that they will know that their help comes from you. Our help comes from you. Our strength comes from you. Guidance comes from you. Direction comes from you. Peace comes from you. For these grandparents who are so worried about their children and grandchildren to where they're getting sick, they've planted the seeds. Now I pray that they'll step back and allow the seeds to grow. I had a conversation earlier this week with a person I've been planting seeds in for a long time. And when that conversation was over, Lord, you told me you did your part. Now let me handle it from here. And I want to share that with those of you in this room and those of you online who have been sharing with other people, speaking into the lives of other people. And it seems like they're not receiving anything you're saying. After a while, you notice you're just repeating the same stuff over and over. It's about time now for you to let God take it. It's about time now for you to back away. But watch this, while you back away, after you've planted into them, you still got to live right because they're still watching you. You still got to live right before them. You got to be a walking, talking example before them and let God take it. Let God handle it. You've done your part. Let God take it from here. He can do more with it than you ever could do. Do y'all receive that? He can do more with it than what you could ever do. And that's to those of you who have been sharing and sharing and sharing and talking and talking and talking and talking and you're tired. God sees that. God sees that. God sees those tears that you've cried because you shared with them. You told them, and they're going the other way. You told them go right, they go left. You told them go down, they go up. God sees that, and he wants you to let him have it. Don't mess up and take it back out of his hands trying to fix it yourself. I repeat this to you today. You've done your part, and God's got a blessing for you. Don't mess your blessing up. Because now you're trying to do his part. Let him handle it from here. Somebody say, Lord, I trust you. Say it again, Lord, I trust you. One more time, Lord, I trust you. We have to do it. We have to do it. We have to do it. God knows how to fix it. He knows how to handle it. So we praise you, Lord. We lift you up. We magnify your name. We trust you. We honor you. We love you. Hallelujah. Even though we don't see it right now, all these seeds we've planted, even though it seems like all we've given, nothing has come back, we still praise you anyhow. We glorify you anyhow because we know that it's coming. We know that it's on the way. And until then, we're going to be sure to walk in your will. Until it comes, we're going to keep you as a priority. And when the blessing comes, you'll still be our priority over the blessing. Yeah, you'll be our priority over the blessing. Yes, Lord, some of us haven't received the blessing yet because you love us enough to say no for a season because you know that we're not mature enough to know how to handle the blessing. This is why we're going to keep praying. This is why we're going to keep seeking you so that we can even be able to handle the blessings that you want to give us. Because you want to give us blessings that we can't even imagine having. Glory to God. You want to give us bank accounts we can't even imagine having. You want to give us spiritual blessings that we can't even imagine. You want to take us to levels that we can't even imagine we would go to. So we're going to keep seeking you. We're going to keep growing in our walk with you so we'll know how to have those doors open for us. And when the doors open, we can maintain it. When the door opens, we won't mess it up. So we say, yes, Lord. We say, yes, Lord. We say, yes, Lord. To those of you who have been, you're some of those people that I'm talking about that have been sharing with other people. You've been talking to other people, talking and talking and talking and talking and talking and talking and texting and emailing and messaging. You're trying to help. You're trying to help this person. You're trying to help that person. You're trying to help this one and that one. Hallelujah. I believe that we're in a faith atmosphere at this moment. And what I would ask you to do as we're in this type of atmosphere is begin to call their name out to God. Begin to call their name out to God. Yes, he knows, but begin to, but you got the power of life in your and death in your tongue. Begin to call their names out to God and say, Lord, they're in your hands. Call their names out and say, Lord, they're in your hands. Come on, let's do that now. Begin to call their names out and say, Lord, they're in your hands. That's it. I hear you saying it. Don't just say, Lord, they're in your hands, but call their names out too and say, Lord, they're in your hands. 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 I give this one to you. I give that one to you. I give this one to you. They're in your hands. They're in your hands. And we trust you to fix it. We trust you to work it out. We trust you, Lord. There's a hymn that says, and these guys almost sure don't know it, but we're going to work through it anyway. I trust in God wherever I may be. Up on the land or on the rolling sea. For come what may, from day to day, my heavenly Father watches over me. I trust in God. I know he cares for me. On mountain bleak or on the stormy sea, though billows roll, he keeps my soul. My heavenly Father watches over me. I trust in God wherever I may be. Up on the land or on the rolling sea. For come what may, from day today, My heavenly Father watches over me. I trust in God. I know He cares for me. On mountain bleak or on the stormy sea, the billows roar, He keeps my soul. My heavenly Father watches over me. I trust in God, for in the lion's den, on battlefield, or in, watch this, in the prison pen, through praise or blame, through flood or flame, my heavenly Father watches over me. One more time. I trust in God. I know He cares for me. On mountain bleak or on the stormy sea, though billows roll, He keeps my soul. Though billows roll, He keeps my soul. Though billows roll, I know He keeps my soul. My heavenly Father watches over me. Glory to God. Glory to God. Lord, we thank You for watching over us by way of our finances. We trust You to fix what needs to be fixed in that area as well. And we're going to do our part. And we're going to do our part. And we're going to give as unto You. Emerald, I need you again. I'm sorry. To get this. Give and it'll be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be put into your bosom. With the same measure that you use, it'll be measured back to you. 2 Corinthians 9:7 says, let each one of us give as is purposed in their heart, not grudgingly or of necessity. The Lord loves a what kind of giver? Cheerful giver. Listen to Psalms 112:5. A good man deals graciously and lends. He'll guide his affairs with discretion. We don't have a problem doing this because we know God is going to guide us. God is going to lead us. And we, with God leading us, with God being our priority, that will help us to guide our affairs with the right mindset. Thank You, Lord. We're going to continue to give. We're not going to stop giving. Because we want a return And there can be no return without any giving that goes out first. So God, we give. We give to the ministry that you've called us to be a part of our tithes and our offering, and we give it consistently. Not just when a certain need comes up, but we give consistently. It's needed every week. We give consistently, and we thank you for having a good ministry to be able to give into. We thank you for having a ministry of integrity that we can give into. We thank you that we have a ministry of character where we can give into. We thank you this is not a position-driven ministry. And it's so heavy in that to where some people just ain't even working because they don't want a position, so they just ain't doing no work. Y'all, some of y'all went the whole opposite way with that part. But we're going to believe God for you to start working. But we thank God that we can definitely say it's not a position-driven ministry. It's in my backpack. And we're not a personality-driven ministry. We're a God-called and God-led ministry. So we thank you in Jesus' name. Everyone stand. We're getting ready to give at this time. I appreciate all of you. I'm glad to see you all. I pray that you all will have a blessed day as you're preparing to go. Mother Tyler is standing here to the side for missions offering, and Minister Draper is standing there. Thank you, Mother. Minister Draper is standing there for your general tithes and offerings. And I'm going to ask those of you online to join us as we give. Everybody, let's do the very, very, very best that we can do. You know your financial situation. So because you heard me say do your best, that, and I didn't give you an amount, that does not mean, please get this in your heart and your spirit, that does not mean be cheap. Because I don't give you an amount does not mean be cheap with God. Did everybody hear that? Amen. Thank you in Jesus' name, amen. You're in the hands of the usher. Deacon, you left somebody back. You stepped right in front of Sister Carrie. You all follow Deacon as he's ushering. All right. Y'all got it together. God bless you all. Here's our Lady Rhonda's offering and my offering here. Glad to see my cousins here today. We have some announcements that are coming before we sign off, before we dismiss. So I'm going to ask everyone to give a listening ear to these announcements at this time.
Good afternoon. Just want to talk to you guys a little bit about our outreach ministry for the homeless. I just want to give you an updated report of how we're moving forward and what we're trying to accomplish. So I'm just going to start by saying that we are continuing to accept donations for non-perishable items. And it looks like we're really doing a great job. So anyone that wants to continue to contribute, it's actually a long-term event, so there is no cutoff date, because how many people know that homelessness is a year-round issue? So we just want you guys to be aware that there's no cutoff date. This is a long-term ministry, so it's not going to go away. If it's the Lord's will, we want to keep moving forward and keep receiving these donations. And for those that aren't able to give or able to make it to the store, we are able to collect cash, and then we can do the shopping for you. So you don't have to worry about running to the store if you're not able to, or getting bulk items. We can do that for you if you don't mind. That's something that we are offering that we can do. The other thing is that we are, because we do have a good inventory started, we're going to start packing our items and bagging them up, and then we have a place that we've located where we can store the items. But the main thing is that we are trying to connect with an outside organization that can mentor us in how to move forward in our ministry, and then they can also support us. So we may be joining another organization. We're looking into that. And so I want you to be aware of why we haven't done anything yet is because we want to feel secure when we go out there. We want to make sure we know what we're doing and that we have someone to kind of instruct us on the how to navigate with the homeless population. So we are just going to start moving forward. Want you to know what's going on, and if you have any questions, you can talk with me, you can talk with Sharon, you can talk with Yolanda that's in the hallway with us. Just if you have any questions, then you want to contribute any money. And then also, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm so pleased with everyone that's participating and how you're showing that you want to be a part of this outreach. Thank you.
Hello, I am here. For a couple of announcements, actually. One being, a while ago, I spoke to you all about trying to get a sort of tutoring session, study hall going together. And I would still like to do that, and the hope is to get that running by August. So if you are knowledgeable and essentially an expert in a certain subject in school, whether it be algebra, earth science, or whatever that might be, I'd like to talk to you about being a tutor. So that's one announcement. Another announcement, I've been talking with Pastor, and we still need youth workers. So if you would like to work in the youth department, I'd also love to speak with you. Last thing, trying to make this quick. But the last thing is, as you all know, I'm hosting a conference called Graced, and it is for girls ages 12 to 18. I realized over time that I haven't really shared exactly what's going to be happening. So a quick rundown of what will be going on. Is we will have some large group sessions, one of which will be one of our large group speakers is actually going to be Ms. Chloe Price. She's going to be sharing her testimony and essentially speaking on what it is to become and like kind of entering into just really who God has called her to be, and showing other young girls that it doesn't have to be a complicated or overly like complex situations. So that's one thing. We've also got some breakout sessions that will be discussing different things like spiritual gifts. Miss Claudette will be teaching. Sister Janae, who is sitting back there, Janae Relaford Davis, will be teaching on making good choices, because that is something we don't really teach people about, but it's so important. So we're going to be talking about making good choices. There's also classes about just like personal style and how to dress well and appropriately, as well as my cousin, who's actually getting her doctorate in psychology, will be with us speaking on mental health. So these are just some of the different discussions that we're going to be having, and we have people who actually know what they're talking about. I actually won't be speaking too much. So I've selected women that I trust and believe are gifted in these different areas that they're going to be speaking and teaching on. So if you know any girl in the age of 12 to 18, come speak with me. I can work something out when it comes to the registration and all that kind of stuff, because we have a lot of sponsors. So yeah, come chat with me. I'd love to get them signed up.
But it's not, and it should never get to the point where it's free.
It is not, correct.
Everybody hear that? Because if our brothers and sisters out in Lenexa did it, it wouldn't be free. So ours shouldn't be. And it's not a money-making thing, but it's too good what's going to be given out for it to be free. Do y'all understand that? All right, I'm sorry.
No, you're good. On that, because that's also something, where's the money going? The money is actually going back into what me and my mom have been working on here, which at the time we called it Little Divas, but we've changed the name to Ladylike. So that sort of monthly meeting that we were having with the girls of CT, we're opening that up to the whole city. And the proceeds of this conference will go towards making that a program worth the girls' while. So that's where the funds are going. Just so you know, I'm not pocketing that money at all. At all. I'm actually investing a lot. So, yeah.
When I said I'm sorry, I was sorry for butting in, but I wasn't sorry for what I said. Everyone stand. We're getting ready to go. We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold. Sickness and poverty must cease, for the devil is defeated. We are blessed. We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field. Blessed when we're come and when we go. We cast down every devil is defeated. We, one more time, one more time. We're blessed in the city, blessed in the field. Blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold. Sickness and poverty must cease. The devil, for the devil is defeated. The devil is defeated. The devil is defeated. The devil is defeated. We are blessed. We are blessed. Late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn it around. He's gonna work in your favor. Late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn it around and around and around and around. You got it, you got it. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you for the service. Lead and guide us as we go. Get the glory in our life. We speak refreshing into the hearts and the minds of each of us who are giving out. And we receive it and thank you for it. Those who are going home by themselves, I pray that they would have an exceptional day. Those who are going out to eat, those who are going with family members or friends or whatever the case may be, we can, no matter what the case is, we can have a great day. We can have a blessed day. No depression allowed. No negative allowed. No worry allowed. Great day, blessed day, beautiful day. We speak it, not just day, matter of fact, week. And we thank you for it. As I go to Ohio this week for the convention, lead and guide, be glorified in what's to take place. And I look forward to seeing the people next Sunday as I start on this series. And I thank you for Christian Tabernacle. We have been through a lot, but we're still standing. Glory to God. We have been through a lot, but we're still here, and we ain't going nowhere. Hallelujah, because you called this ministry. Not me, not my father, not anybody else. You called CT, so we ain't going nowhere. The devil is defeated. We're a blessed church. Everybody say, we're a blessed church. Say it again, we're a blessed church. I declare, I speak over CT that blessings come from north, south, east, and west. Hallelujah. And we receive it and thank you for it. We'll keep you as our priority, Lord. We'll keep seeking you first. Bless Sister Nunny as she speaks and teaches and leads on Wednesday night. You've put your word in her heart. She don't give spiritual fluff. She gives out spiritual substance. Cover her, lead her, protect her, so that she can stand before your people and minister to them on Wednesday night. And we praise you, Deacon Lewis and Mother, as they minister to people on Tuesday in day service. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for CT. We're a blessed church. We're gonna close out singing again. Come on. We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field. Come on, Clarence. Blessed in, that's it. When we go, y'all can shake somebody's hands and tell them we're a blessed church. The devil is defeated. We are blessed. One more time. We're blessed in the city.